Have you ever been like where you're playing music in the car? Has anyone ever put headphones on while you play music?
Yeah.
And it's like,
oh, like, for real,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah.
You don't like me that much.
I was jumping the back seat.
Fuck you.
I was sock you from the back seat.
Yeah.
From the front seat.
That's true.
No, because I've seen that a million times, but it's usually like a young ass dude that does that to me, though, a lot of the times.
Yeah.
Because, like, I remember I was fucking with this one bitch. And her little brother, I used to give them their family rides and shit to, like, certain places.
Yeah.
And her little brother would always just be like, in my head, I'm just like, fuck you.
You disrespectful little shit.
You little piece of shit. That's why I'm putting my dick in your sister's mouth.
Wow. That's how you felt, huh?
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
It's like, nigga, I bought you McDonald's.
And you're gonna put your fucking headphones in? I'm fucking her extra good.
God.
I'm fucking her.
Put her in the butt tonight.
Tonight, as far as I can see, I wanna keep you here.
I can't imagine like being 20 years old and this came out, bruh. I'm impregnating every woman.
Random question, but I just thought of it right now. What's your biggest vice?
What's a vice?
A vice, I guess, is something that's like a bad habit. Something that's like, it could be alcohol, procrastination, putting shit off. It could be fucking smoking, drinking. It could be like anything, and that's like anything that's kind of bad, but it's just a habit of yours that you just kind of do.
I'm definitely impulsive.
That you kind of need.
I'm very impulsive. And that could be good and bad. Like, I could be chilling, about to go to sleep, and then I'll think of an idea or something like that, and then now I'm up again,
man,
because I have to do it right now because I feel like I'll forget it in the morning.
You need to start writing in your notes. Do you write in your notes?
I do, but I still just feel like I gotta see. I have to see it right now.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
So I'm just like, all right, fuck. And that's how I end up staying up till 4 a.m.
I have the same bad habit. What do I do though? Like, I'll kind of like write down my ideas. Like, I'll describe it to myself to where I can kind of understand. So I'll kind of go into detail about it. So as soon as I think about it, I'm like, fuck whatever I'm doing right now. Like, I'm just like, all right, this is now like this before this and make it this way. Da, da, da. Like, I'll write down every little detail. So like, I kind of know what I was thinking at the time.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was just curious. I don't think I ever asked you that, but like when you were talking about it, I was just kind of curious of what your vices were.
Yeah, it's definitely being impulsive.
You don't have any more? I'm sure you have more.
I
mean, we all have vices.
Like things that are bad? Is it vice?
Yeah, pretty much a vice is pretty much like something that's like...
But what's bad? Like bad is... I feel like...
Let me look up the definition so I could like kind of explain it more.
I feel like a vice is just all depends on what type of person you are. Like,
it's pretty much like an immoral, like pretty much like in right here it says immoral or wicked behavior. So like I said, like it's pretty much, it's just like a bad habit that you have.
That's very subjective, honestly. But
so something like, it could be, like I said, drinking, smoking, procrastination, fucking not wanting to work when you need to. Fucking just a bad habit. Pretty much just a bad habit. A bad habit.
Mm-hmm. I could be better with money, but I don't think that's a vice.
It kind of is.
Yeah, I guess. I could be better with my money management, most definitely.
I remember when I met your mom, she said the same thing. She was like, man, you know, just, he needs to do the same thing. And I was like, yeah. But I was telling her, I was like, yo, like I try to like pull out a certain amount of money and then save the rest.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I don't do that all the time, I need to start doing that again because that shit really works. But she was like, yeah, you know, someone needs to learn from that. And she was going to start looking at you.
Yep, that's my mom. I love her.
Yeah, no, your mom's cool as shit. I fuck with your mom.
I'm just definitely one of those people that feels like I should live it up most as I can, because
yeah,
what if I die and I don't do the things that I feel like I should, or I didn't get that thing that I felt like I should and I didn't because I'm trying to save for something, even though tomorrow is never guaranteed.
Yeah. Like,
so it's, I don't know. It's a big,
that's like a thin big line, because you do need to save money, but like, don't save money. It's where you're just like, not spending anything. Of course, you know, like spend money, have a good time, but also like be safe, you know, like leave a comfortable cushion. But at the same time, though, still spend money and have fun, though. But just find that balance, though. I think that's where the big problem happens, where people don't find that balance.
I always just figured, hey, just make more money. Like,
yeah, but see, if you do that, though, then the more money you make, the more that you're going to keep using that same excuse, and that same excuse will kind of get you fucked.
True.
Like, you respect because you can make a million, and if you have a bad habit of spending money, that million is gone.
What's interesting is that it's the in between, well, not in between a million, but like, you can make a decent amount of money, fuck it off, whatever. But not a lot of people actually get the opportunity to have. Mm-hmm. If I did have $500,000, let's just say that, dude, of course, like, I'm not going to run through $500,000. Like, I could put away $250,000. Like, my morals are still, like, I still don't need everything in the world. If I made $500,000, I would definitely put away $400,000. And I would feel like $100,000 is $1 million. And I think that's just because, like, just the way that I was raised and, like, all that type of shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like I could do so much with $100,000 right now.
Yeah.
Like, so much, bro. It wouldn't go towards clothes or anything. It would definitely be, like, traveling, investing in myself, shit like that. But you don't really get that. You don't get the opportunity. Not a lot of people do. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's interesting that, you know, people judge, or people, I don't want to say judge, but all I want to say is that not a lot of people get the opportunity to have big amounts of money to the point where they can actually save. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, like, making $10,000, like, sure, that's a good amount of money, but still, you don't really essentially get to, like, save a lot. I don't know. At least that's for me. Like, I guess, making money, having a good amount of money. I just want to enjoy life.
Yeah.
Yeah. So when I do have it, it's just like, cool. Like, now I get to, like, live more.
No, I mean, that's understandable, bro. Cause I'm the same way, like how I was talking about earlier about, cause we were, before the podcast started, we started watching the Ashanti and Keyshia Cole battle. And I was telling Nick how about, like, these battles are like, people look at them like, oh, this is cool entertainment, but it's like, no, like, these will never happen ever again. And I was kind of telling him also, like, I think it was in the group chat, but I was saying, like, what they need to do, or pretty much what I was hoping for, is when all this corona shit's over, I hope they start making these versus battles live concerts. But I don't know if they will or not, but, like, just regardless if they don't, whatever the fuck, but these moments are big moments, because never in a million years I guarantee you, hip-hop fans all over the world were always like, yo, what if RZA and DJ Premier did a fucking battle? We got to watch that on Versus. What if Gucci Mane and fucking Jeezy did a battle? We got to watch that on Versus.
Yeah.
What if fucking Keyshia Cole and fucking Ashanti did a battle? We just watched that. What if, and just et cetera, like, we're literally watching history happen, and it's cool as fuck, especially for music lovers like myself, and I know Nick loves music, so shit like this is, to me, I take in these big moments. I take in these moments that I know are not going to last forever, and people might overlook, be like, oh, you know, that's cool, you know, I'll watch it later, you know, like, they'll watch and kind of forget about it, but, like, I will not forget about shit like this. Like, I soak in shit like this, and I was telling you earlier, same thing with Stephen Curry, LeBron James, these big NBA players, like, these are legends, and I'm watching them, and I'm taking that in. Like, you're not going to see shit like this ever again. They're going to set the tone for the next fucking generation.
It's definitely it's a great concept, the versus. In the right hands and the right mind, could definitely make millions for sure.
Damn, I kind of got off subject about the whole money part, because I was kind of going off living in the moment, and then I ventured off into the music shit. But fucking going back to the money shit, yeah, like, live in the moment, but also, you know, still also be smart too. Because it is very important to live in the moment and have fun, but it's also important to also be smart and make sure you have something saved up just in case emergencies happen and shit. Mm-hmm. You don't want to get yourself stuck in a situation that you can't get out of. But definitely 100% have fun, because I have fun all the time. And
yeah,
man, like, I mean, we could both say we have fun a lot, bro. Like,
yeah,
we definitely both have, like, we kind of like, especially when I talk to other people, I'm just like, yeah, we don't live the same life. Like, we live very, very different lives.
Definitely. I think that has a lot to do with my friends too, though, at the same time.
It's a big thing also. Mm-hmm. Yeah. For sure. Because whenever, yeah, because I mean, Keem is the one who brought me out to Arizona. Opened up for Sada Baby and shit. Like, if it wasn't for Keem, I wouldn't have been there.
Yeah.
And a lot of times too, like, because me and Keem are like, let's do this. Fuck it. We go.
Mm-hmm.
We just do it. So like, and then same thing with you, like same thing with you and shit. Like, I would have never went to LA and had that 7-day trip. It wasn't for you. And just a bunch of other shit, you know, like we all have things we bring to each other. Like, if it wasn't for this podcast, we wouldn't be doing it right now, you know? So like,
yeah, I think it's so crazy that that one trip is very significant to me and Will's friendship.
It's literally like so important.
And, like, to me, Jose and Will's friendship, like,
that one trip.
Just, I don't know why it just means so fucking much. Like, dude, this one trip.
It's about to be a year since it happened. I think, I don't know if we talked about it in the last podcast, but honestly, on some shit, if you're going to keep listening to this podcast, you're going to hear this get brought up a lot of times because it's just so important to us. And it's y'all just so reminiscent. Y'all have to
go watch that shit.
Yeah, if y'all don't watch it, like, man, if you guys watch it, you'll see why. And honestly, like, you guys didn't even see the whole thing. Like, I put a lot of shit in there. But there's stuff that I didn't even shoot on camera that was still crazy as fuck. Like, because I was drunk as shit a lot of that time too. Like, we were all shit faced throughout the whole 7 days.
Mm-hmm.
So there's so much shit that I didn't even get to record because I was just fucked up with you guys. You feel me? Like,
yeah.
Like, yeah. Oh man. But yeah, no, definitely live your guys' fucking life, man. Just like, there's so many people that I said, like, just, it goes back to me going back to work and shit. It's just like, or just regular people that you meet or and shit like that. And it's just like, you talk to them and you're like, oh, what do you do? Or what did you do on the weekend? And it's just like, oh, I didn't do anything. It's just like,
nothing.
You don't have a hobby.
Yeah.
You don't have like an interest. You don't do art. You're not interested in clothes, music, like nothing. You just did nothing. Like, you didn't do anything that you love. Like, you just sat around and watched TV all your days off and went back to work. Like, that's when you become a robot.
Mm-hmm.
And that, to me, it's like, that's what I fear the most. That's what I'm saying. I say this all the time and I'll never stop saying it. If I ever work a 9-to-5 for the rest of my life, just know I'll be fucking miserable. I will dead ass be depressed and I never want to get there. Cause
yeah,
no.
Yeah.
Never. I'll never do that. But yeah, man, I don't know. But yeah, definitely live your guys' fucking life, man. Cause life is fucking short. And what he was saying too, like, if he dies, you know, he's like, what do I save this money for? And Kimo said the same thing too. But at the same time, it's just like, but you don't know what's going to happen. It's like, you can die a second from now, or you could live 90 years. You don't know. So that's why you need that money to save just in case.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just say you spend all that money and shit and you end up living till 90. And it's just like, fuck, all that money I had, now where's it at?
You know? Right. I just held on to it. It's not a bad thing, you know, especially if you have kids, you know, it's to leave something to your legacy, no doubt. I think that's why it's a interesting, being an entrepreneur is an interesting route for sure. I mean, any entrepreneur out there knows there could be months where you don't make, where you make $100, and there could be months where you make $2,000, $3,000.
Yeah.
And I think that's fucking wild. It's, I'm still learning till right now, you know, I feel like I'll always be learning to be okay with that. Because it's just like, damn, dude, like, I don't have fucking shit for money. Like, I have just enough, because obviously you have to pay your bills still. So like, you make ends meet, and then that's it. Like, you just make ends meet, like, just at that. But and then there's other months where you have extra money to like do whatever you want to do, or you know, save it or whatever. But for real, honestly, being an entrepreneur is definitely, I mean, an entrepreneur that is still on the rise, you're definitely still on edge the whole entire time.
Yeah,
there's no really no time to chill. There's always you always feel like
you have to use your time.
Yeah, you always feel like, all right, what can I do to like make, not necessarily make more money. I feel like it depends on what kind of thing that you're into. Like for artistry, like you don't really want to sacrifice your art to make money, but it's really hard not to, you know. And I think that's what a lot of artists deal with when it comes to art. You know, you want to make something that people like and that's likable and relevant. Even if you don't like it, you know what I'm saying? It's hard, you know, it's definitely hard. And then for the people that don't understand your situation, you got to kind of explain that to them. Cause you know, you're trying to progress. You're always trying to progress, move forward, make new ideas, while kind of still trying to satisfy these people for these ideas. You know what I'm saying?
Try to keep this in front of you.
Oh, okay.
I feel like just move it as much as you can.
Okay. I feel like the mic be kind of good, bro. Cause when I watched the thing with Ivan, like I was not near that shit at all. But yeah, like no, you can still hear me, bro.
Like you can hear you, but like when you do it like how like whenever you put it close to you, you hear the difference.
Mm-hmm.
It's like whenever I watch podcasts, someone's like this, you can still hear them. But once they do this, huge difference.
Mm-hmm.
That's saying just like the little shit. So it's saying just try as much as just try. But
fuck you, Will. Always trying to tell you what to do. Fuck this bastard.
When it comes to this, I kind of, you know.
So just no. I was gonna say suck my dick.
Ooh, should we play this right now? Yes, let's do it. I'm not gonna lie though, I did like the way we started. We talked about a lot of good shit. We got very, very deep. Got a lot of good shit. But for whoever is listening and you can't see what I have right here, and even if you do see what I have right here on camera, you're probably not gonna know what this is. This is a Russian roulette game. There's what, 2, 4, there's 6 slots. Everyone puts their finger in a slot. You press the start button, and whoever it picks, it shocks you.
Fuck this asshole.
And whoever loses right now has to take a shot. I mean, let's take a shot right now, and then we'll do that.
Fuck you.
Let's take a shot first, and then we're going to get Keem in here, a.k.a. Kit Game Keem. We're gonna get him in here. He might be asleep.
Go get Keem.
He might be asleep, but we're gonna wake his.
I don't want to play without him.
Yeah, no, we're gonna do it. And if he's not gonna do it, then we're still gonna play. So we have to.
If you guys don't know, we're watching Goodfellas.
And if you don't, Harry Potter, for yourself.
Jesus, you almost fucked up so hard.
Because if you don't know this movie, then go and please watch it. I'm not gonna sit here and talk shit to you, even though I should, but I'm not going to. Because I love you guys. You guys are good people. You want to take some of my shot? I poured a lot.
Fuck no.
Just a little bit. Take a little bit of my shot, brother.
In the arms of the angel.
That was a nice no. That was a very beautiful way to say no. Okay, so let's take this shot right now.
I hope y'all know the song I'm singing.
I'm not gonna lie though, that's a fucking such a depressing song.
Dude, when I heard that shit 3 o'clock in the morning.
You're watching the one-eyed dog, the cat with 3 fucking legs, the burned fucking, just the burned animals.
Dude, the dog is just shivering. He's just like
scared.
He's like, ugh.
Bro, that's just the, oh my God, it's the worst.
Huh? And then it's this bitch. Sorry, she's
not a bitch. Bitch.
She's not a bitch. It's this lady.
She might be though, because you don't know where those proceeds are going.
Yeah.
Who remembers Kony 2012? You remember that?
Yeah.
That shit was fake.
What did that even mean?
Because basically it was this dude in the... Honestly, you know, I don't know. I was about to explain it.
It was this dude in the trap.
Yeah, this dude in the trap, you know what I'm saying? I guess he
was killing kids or something.
Basically, I guess like this guy back in the day was like fucking kidnapping kids, all types of shit. But basically when that shit came out though, the guys who were doing the whole Kony 2012 campaign... That shit was years before that.
Yeah.
So when they did the campaign, they're just re-emerging something that the U.S. didn't know about.
Yeah.
And then capitalized on it. And I remember Timothy Delgado, shout out to everyone who knows who that is. He was doing a YouTube video and he was like, yo, I support it, but I'm not putting my, he's like, I'm not going to put money into this until I know exactly where it's going.
Mm-hmm.
Smart man, because months later, fake.
Fake news.
Fake, and these niggas made probably millions. And I remember everyone at my school had Kony fucking 2012 buttons. And I'm not here to shit on you guys because you guys were there for like a good reason. You guys were thinking you guys were doing a good thing. I mean, you guys were doing a good thing, you know, realistically. But at the end of the day, it ended up being fake. That's why always make sure you know where your money's coming from. That's why at Walmart, I don't fucking give money to any of those donations.
Nah, bro.
Fuck no.
Look, if you don't have, if you...
And they make you feel like a piece of shit when you press no. But it's like, yeah, that's not going to get me. I'm going to press no every fucking time.
I'm not giving money to nobody unless you have no shoes on, black ass feet, you're cracked out, and I can see that.
I still be giving money out. Honestly, you've seen the t-shirts I have.
What do you mean?
You never seen my pile of white t-shirts?
Oh, yeah. Do you give those out?
I'm about to. Because right now, I probably have 100 at least.
Damn.
Or at least over 100.
It's pretty... I mean, you can... Niggas gonna have dirty white
t-shirts. I'm not about to... No, because I wore all of them one time. But I'm gonna wash all of them. They're all gonna get washed.
This is those two bags? I mean, the ones that are right there?
So there's one full ass one that I can't fill no more, and there's one that's half. But once I put all this in here that I have in my dirty clothes right now, that'll fill up the second one.
Why don't you just wash them all? Do you not wash?
That's what I was going to do. That's what I'm telling you.
Okay.
That's what I just said.
It's not.
What I just say then?
You said, I'm going to give them away because I'm a good Samaritan.
And then I said, I'm going to wash them all first.
You should.
That's what I said.
They're still washed.
It's on camera.
You only wore them once.
Yeah, I'm not going to give them a shirt that I wore, though. I'm going to wash them first.
You're sick.
How am I sick? I'm not going to give them a shirt that I washed. I mean, I'm not giving them a shirt that I wore.
You don't want to feel the connection of being close to someone?
I'd rather give someone a fucking shirt that's never been worn. I mean, at least it's been worn, but not fucking dirty still. I want to give them something that's still clean.
This shit's not dirty. You wore it once.
Still, I'd rather wash it. Just because they're homeless, what the fuck? I'm not going to give them a fucking shirt that I've already wore.
All they're going to do is lay on the fucking ground, Will.
I don't care.
There's going to be black tar spots.
They're still human.
There's going to be... They're human. They're human. But
I'm gonna give away my Air Forces too because I have too many.
You gotta realize they're laying on the ground.
Yeah, I don't care though. I'm not gonna give them dirt. I'm not gonna give them a shirt that has like a little bit of smell right here. Like
they will wear a shirt that has 10 holes in it.
Yeah, but
and be thankful.
I'd rather give them a clean one. That's me though.
Understandable.
I don't know. I'm not giving them a shirt that's fucking half dirty. Like nah, I'm gonna give them a clean shirt, man.
I give him a dirty shirt, bro. Fuck that shit.
Mm-mm, I can't do that, man.
Especially if it's some sauce. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I'm giving them white tees, though.
White tees or sauce.
Honestly, I'm probably gonna give out packs of three. Each person gets a pack of three.
Let me know when you go do that.
Yeah, for sure.
I want to be there for that.
Yeah. I don't want to record it though. I'm not filming that.
No, that's weak.
That's whack. And I remember one time I put it on Twitter because one guy was like, hey, come here, bro. And then he was in some deli because he owned like a bodega or something. And he's like, yo, come here. He's like, you want this? And just gave him a bunch of free shit. And pretty much just recorded him. I'm like, bro, like, you're a weirdo.
Bro.
You're a weird, like, why are you recording this homeless person who's in a bad situation?
You niggas is all weird that do that shit, bro.
Because
I don't care what you say.
It's because you think, like, you think
I don't give a fuck how much food you give away. You're fucking weird. You want clout for doing, like, nice shit.
Never in my life.
Fucking weirdos.
I always see YouTubers too. They always do these videos where, like, yo, like, we do a homeless makeover. Like, bro, you're doing that for views. That shit is so fucking trash to me. Like, you picked up a homeless person, put them on camera without even asking them, then went and got them a makeover. So you're pretty much just showing them when they're shitty. And it's just like, bro, to me, that's just such garbage to me, bro. Like, that's not even cool. Like, at the end of the day, yes, yeah, you did help that person. You did make them feel better, whatever the fuck. But
basically,
you don't need to put that on camera, though.
You showing me, you just want to show that you're a good person.
You want to feel like you're a good person. It's like, man, fuck that, bro. Like, everything I do, I would never put out. The only time I ever did go on social media was when I asked, like, yo, who has nephew? I was like, pretty much like, yo, like, do you guys, because I had like 50 white t-shirts that I just washed. And I was like, yo, who has family or who knows a place where I can go and just drop these off? Not a charity, but I want to go and, like, go to a certain place, or, like, mm-hmm. if you have any nephews or nieces that are in need, that need white tees, and I'll fucking shoot them right here. They're all fucking one time washed, brand new.
Yeah.
But other than that, no, like, I'm not fucking doing that. To me, that shit's so whack, bro. Like, I don't know. You're doing that shit for clout. And if you're doing that shit for clout, that's not genuine.
You just got to do shit off the strength, man.
I think if you're doing that, you're a piece of shit. To be honest with you.
You got to do it off the strength.
Nobody needs to see that.
It feels better.
Like, why do people need to see that? Why?
Mm-hmm.
I've heard people say,
you just showing a nigga that's down bad, bro. Like, what the fuck?
Because think about it. Imagine you.
So weird, bro.
Imagine you. You're sitting there and you're in a bad position. You're homeless. You're you're not dressed how you wish you could dress.
And the nigga's in your face with a camera, bro.
They're in your face with a camera like, hey, bro, the blood. And it's like, bro, you think they want that?
Weird.
But guess what? They're going to deal with it because they know you're going to give them something. So they're going to deal with it. But realistically, they don't fucking want that. That's embarrassing.
Yeah.
You're embarrassing that person in front of however fucking hundred thousands or millions of views you get. That's embarrassing, bro. Man, I don't give a fuck how much y'all think you're helping. You are a piece of shit. You're a piece of shit. Any of you guys, if you take offense to it.
You're not a whole piece of shit, but you're definitely a little.
Yeah, you're not a whole piece of shit, but you're still a piece of shit.
You're a little droplet.
And if you take offense to this, you can suck my dick. Because I think you're a piece of shit.
Yeah, because Will's from New York, so suck his dick.
No, but I genuinely do think that people do that are pieces of shit. So you can suck my dick about that. Yeah.
It's crazy, man. People, this society is so fucked. People don't think, like if you don't post something or do something, like posting something is the receipts to this world. And that's so weird.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not a good person. Like, people don't think I do good things, or like, I've given away so much free shit and so many free hats. So,
but you don't need to post it though.
Like, to all my little cousins and shit, bro. Like, but why post this shit? I just do it because it makes me happy and I'm able to do that and to do something, because, like, I feel like even on a more, like, deeper tip, far as, like, being in a relationship, I feel like some people, like,
want you to post them.
No, some relationships, they're counting favors, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's the same type of shit, though, like, oh, like, I bought you this and that and that, so you gotta treat me this way, or you gotta buy me the same shit, or whatever.
But see, relationships like that, that's not what you need to be in.
That's weirdo energy, bro.
That's very
weird. If you can't do that shit out of love, bro, don't do it for me, bro.
Exactly.
Don't do it for me.
Like, if you're doing things for me, and in your head, you're like, I want something back, don't even do it.
Yeah, like, if you bring
up... Because that's not what it's about.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you do shit, you're doing it out of love. Because for me, like, when I do anything for anybody, not that I'm expecting anything back, but I don't even want anything back. Like, I'm not expecting it. I don't want it. Like, I just, I don't care if you do anything back. I'm just doing it because that's just me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not even thinking about that when I do it. Because all the times when I do shit, it's just off just like random. I'm like, hey, you want this? Boom, take it.
Yeah.
That's why I give away a lot of my clothes. I'm just like, I don't wear it. So here, someone take it. Because if my little brother can't fit it, because he's the same size as me. So if my little brother can't take it, so he's gonna be the first one I give it as he's gonna be the first one I give it to.
Yeah.
But if he can't take it, somebody just. And I say I'm gonna start doing more raffles too, because that shit's fun. It's fun. But people that just barely follow me just for that raffle, I count y'all out. I don't care. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't get it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, man. It's just.
Because I noticed on my last raffle, I think I got like 50 to close to 60. And some of them, like, they just joined just for the raffle. I'm like, no. I'm not giving one jacket to you.
I mean, that's part of the get. It's, dude, free stuff is always going to.
Yeah, but at the same time, like, it's funny because I did pick a name and I was like, all right, they won. And then I ended the live. I looked at the profile. I was like, they just followed me like a couple hours ago. I'm like, no, that doesn't feel like it just didn't feel right.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, you know, like, I'm going to keep the same two that I already had because I went from. I don't know. I think I went from like 9 to 6 to 3. Mm. And then I picked the 1. And that's around there, whatever the fuck, that's when the person got picked. But I was like, nah, fuck that. I'm going to keep the same 2 that I already had before. And I'm picking a new one. And that person is going to go in there. And then we're going to do it again. And that 1 out of the 3 is going to win. And that's when the one person won. I still didn't give you your jacket, bro. I'm sorry. It's been months. I mean, it's been a month, and I know. I'm sorry. Because I told him I caught COVID, so he knows. But you're still getting the jacket, bro. Trust me. Because I said, I can't wear it. It doesn't fit me and shit. So, and it's going to fit him, too, because he's a shorter dude. So it's going to fit him perfectly, probably.
Yeah.
But, yeah, man. I don't know. But, yeah. At the end of the day, if you're out here fucking posting yourself, giving shit to homeless people.
Fuck.
Honestly, every single time you do that, I don't give a fuck if it's being a good person out of your heart. To me, I don't like that. It rubs me the wrong way.
Corny and weird.
It rubs me the wrong way every single time. Every time. Every single time. So, yeah. But on a lighter note, we're going to play this game right now. So I'm going to get Keem. I'm going to go pee first, and then I'm going to get Keem. And we're gonna play this fucking game.
Young babe, guy, can't. Where's?
Hopefully he's not a
star. I want to play a song, but it'll be a song that won't be monetized, copyrighted.
Where are you gonna playing?
I hate you. How about that? Look, guys, I never really liked Will. He's an idiot, and I hate him. Well, since he's gone, these are 3 of my hats right here. If you could see these, I'm fire, bruh. Honestly, no one's really seeing me with this hat shit, bruh. But I'm gonna leave it at that. I can't believe these niggas really compare me to other niggas, bro. But, all right, look. We're going to play Shot Game. I'm pretty faded. I lost my glasses. My glasses have these gel things for my nose.
He's down.
What the fuck? I was telling a story.
All right, you're going to go in the middle. We're gonna bring that fucking thing down. Just please don't, if you do get shocked, just please don't break too much. We got a TV and a lot of other shit around
us.
I'm
breaking the TV, honestly.
Oh, shit. This is going to be crazy. All right, so.
I don't want to play this.
Yeah, but you kind of have to.
Knee, but I'm not
you want a shot about it?
Where's the, I need a glass.
Here. Take a shot about it, brother.
Oh, I don't get no chaser, no nothing?
No.
Wow.
We are You're like 30 years old. Come on.
Fuck you. I'm 25.
Oh, my exes.
You're not going to take a shot?
Exes.
We're talking about the game, right?
Oh, as whoever loses, got to take a shot.
We haven't started playing yet.
Okay, here we go. All right.
All right, everybody participate.
I don't want to play.
Oh, I'm going to see if it's on first.
I am scared.
Don't be a bitch.
Oh, fuck. All right, it's on. All right. My hands are sweaty.
Two sides.
No, it's the whole thing, bro. Trust me.
No, it's
you
not.
Sure?
It's one and two.
Yeah, it's
what
one
are you
and
talking
two.
About, bro?
Do all sides and put everybody put a finger in.
Oh, wait, my hands are not this way. This way. Wait. All right, like this.
No, just everybody put two fingers in.
No,
more risky.
Fuck you, asshole.
Jump.
I don't want to do it.
I'm scared, nigga. Fuck this.
I'm scared too.
Ah!
Ah! All right. Fuck. I'm fucking scared. I'm not going to lie to you.
Nigga, I don't want to do this.
Put your finger there. You
I don't
want to
do it.
Let's go.
You want to take that shot first?
No, come on, go. Pussy.
All right, put your finger down, though.
No, put it down, bro. Stop right, playing. Right. Look.
All right, it's down.
It's not down. You have a
get
job.
Off me. Get off me.
No. If you're not going to do it, don't
it
do
down,
it.
Down, bro.
I'm going to do it. It's down.
I'm fucking scared. Put your fucking finger down. It's not down. It's not down.
Look, it's down.
All right, keep it like that, please.
All right.
Bro, dead ass.
It's down.
If you're not gonna play, don't play.
It's down.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck. I don't like this.
Nigga, you pulled out.
It shocked me.
No, you didn't play.
I felt it.
Out.
Wow.
It was a little bit. I felt a little bit.
Take this shot.
All right. Well, no, I did everybody.
They didn't shock
me. I did all three.
No,
it didn't shock me.
We got to do it again.
He pulled out.
It didn't go on me. It went on you. But if
I did it.
But it went on everybody. All right, one time.
He pulled out.
All right. Fuck.
Ah! Oh, it went on both of us. I didn't feel it, though.
You didn't feel it?
No. You're just not a little bitch. Little bitch.
All right, look. We got a Rambo right here.
Two fingers each. Oh my god, this is sick. Oh my god. Oh, this is ass. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, that feels weird. All right, so it's not that bad. It's like a little like, it's not that bad. It's more scary than anything. You didn't feel that?
I haven't put my fingers down this whole time.
Wow, see, what the fuck?
Fucking capper.
This is a trap. All right, I'll put it down this time. Come on.
Nah, you gotta give me a shot by yourself now.
Fuck you.
You gotta feel it.
Stop. It's down.
Bro, Kimi doesn't feel it, bro. Honestly, it's not that bad. You know, like the shock pins?
Mm-hmm.
It feels like that.
He made it seem worse earlier.
I know he did. You need to feel it by yourself.
I don't like how it feels, bro.
You need to feel it by yourself. No. Let's...
It makes me not feel good about myself.
What the fuck?
Nah, bro.
I don't want
you're, to. You're a bitch, though.
Put your goddamn finger on there.
It wasn't even on me. What do you want from me?
You don't have your fucking finger on it, do you?
No.
Get out of my room.
I
no, you have to fucking do it one time.
All right.
Dead ass is fucking right, do it.
Go. It's down. Get off me. You lifted it up. It's down.
All
right. Y'all don't make mistakes, bro.
It's okay. I got you.
Watch, you feel it?
That's a light shot.
It's like the gum thing. Yeah, yeah. See? Take fucking bitch. Out. Yeah, take a shot and get out of here.
I mean, you guys be shocked up.
Oh my god.
It's not that bad. It's not that bad. It's more scary than anything.
You know, chasing
someone? Oh my god. You are fucking what, 70 years old? Get out of here. Come on, take the shot.
He's older than me.
You shed hair like you're 70.
Come on, take the shot now.
I want to clear exit so I can go get a chase.
No, take a shot now.
It's my shot, guys. What are you talking about? Yeah, I want to clear exit.
We have no chaser, so just take it.
I'm going to go downstairs.
So
right now. Take a shot now.
Shout out to Kid Game King for cheating. Which it was usual him. It was usual for a guy like this to cheat. He cheats in general. Just like you guys know, ladies, he cheats in general. He cheats. He's a cheater.
Yep, definitely a cheater. I respect you though.
It's not that bad,
ladies. It's all cap. It's all cap. I do not cheat.
He cheats.
He's gonna be bald in 2 years. That wasn't that bad.
Hachim. All right, let's do a one-on-one.
I don't like how it feels, and I keep telling you this.
All right, we're going to do one more.
It makes me feel like I'm dying inside.
All right, we're going to do one more.
Where is it at? Which side? This one?
Mm-hmm. All right, we're doing one more. Don't fucking cheat.
I got scared, guys. I'm scared of it. I'm scared for other people.
I love this game, bro. This game is so great.
All right. I don't like pain.
I'll take a shot for it.
Except when it's tattoos.
Just my whole hand feels kind of tingly.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
So yeah, this game, honestly, guys, it's not as bad as it's more scary just because you don't know what's going to happen. That's the scary part. And then when you get shocked, that's like the part that makes you react crazy. But as far as the shot goes, I'll tell you guys, it feels kind of like when you have that piece of gum candy, little shock thing. It feels like that, or it feels like when you have the pen and you press it down. And honestly, that pen, remember the pen?
Yeah.
That felt worse than that. That pen was strong. Because I remember my older brother was like, yo, hey, draw something. And I was like, okay, yeah. Like, as a little kid, I was like, oh, my God. Bro, that was the pen was a strong, that was a strong shock.
Damn.
The pen one was bad. That one was really strong.
Fuck that.
This one's pretty light though. This one's not that bad.
Fuck that shit, bro.
But it doesn't feel how you explained it earlier though. Maybe for you it does.
I don't like it. It makes me uncomfortable.
It's fucking scary. It's fucking scary.
So uncomfortable, okay.
Oh, I'm glad we got that though. Oh, where's my phone at? Oh man, so we talked about a lot so far, but let's talk about shit. Well, I just came back from Arizona. I went to out of state for the very first time in my whole entire life. Mm-hmm. It was pretty tight. We went out of state for Keem, aka Kid Game Keem. He had a show out of state for Asada Baby. He was opening for Asada Baby, so he blessed me with coming with him. And that shit was fun. And it was funny because this one bitch in the front of the crowd, she was like this. She was like, fuck you. We want Sada Baby. We want Sada. Hey, bro. Okay, so you know how usually every concert has like five openers and shit? This one had 15.
That's a lot of openers.
Bread. At least 15 openers, right? So when Keem came out, was one bitch was like, yeah, fuck you. Flipping him off and shit. Fuck you. We want Sada Baby.
Her white bitch?
Black. She was like, fuck, you want a soda, baby? But she was acting like a white girl. But I think she was acting like that just because, like, she's probably in front of her friends. She was drunk, just being hella young and Arizona stupid and shit. Arizona is
the home of the white people, bro.
Yeah, but she was acting like she's never been to a concert before, basically. So I was just like, yeah, this bitch is fucking acting retarded. But Keem was like, yeah, hey, like, I fuck with you. You're hella funny. Da, da, da. And so later on during the concert, like, yeah. But no, okay, I'll say this too. So at the end of Keem's set, his last two songs, that same bitch that was like, fuck you, was going crazy to his last two songs.
Hard.
So I'm like, it's cool. Yeah, you won her over, but still, it's like, bitch, just like, shut up, you know? But that's then, good. And when Soda Baby came out, because obviously we have like guest passes and shit, so we're able to walk wherever we want. So I was like in front of the barricades. Like I stood on the barricade and I was in front of the crowd and I was like holding my camera up to record Soda. And this one bitch was like, yo, move the fuck out the way. Move out my way. And I was like, I turned around and I was like,
fuck you.
I was like, nah, no. Because if you would have asked me nice, I would have moved without no problem.
Mm-hmm.
But since you asked like that, nah, fuck no. So I stood in front of him for like 10 minutes. Just out of spite. I was like, fuck you.
It's the drunk white hoes.
And I was like, bitch, are you in front of the barricade? I don't think so. I'm right here.
You sit your pretty little ass behind that barricade.
You sit behind the barricade.
Right now.
Shut your dumb ass up. So I was in front of her and I was just like this. And this one guy was like, hey, bro, move over for the girls, bro. And bro, I turned around, looked dead in his eyes and was like this. No emotion, no smile, just like this. Like at least 30 seconds.
So you just simped.
And I was just like, pretty much just like, yo, fuck you. Fuck what you want.
And fuck them bitches.
And fuck them bitches too. Wow. But just with my eyes though.
Savage.
Didn't say shit. And I was like, I was like, exactly. I didn't say anything. And then she kept going. And I was just like, I was yelling back at her too. And there's one part where I wanted her to feel stupid. So I had a line. I was like, that nigga Soda hired me to be here. Fuck you, bitch. Cause I just wanted to talk shit, but I was like, I just wanted to be stupid and talk shit. So like, yeah, fuck you, bitch, blah, blah, blah. And then I stayed in front of her for like maybe like five more minutes and shit. And then I got down. I was like, there you go. Like,
there you go. There you go. Stupid idiot.
But yeah, no. If she would have asked me nicely, I'd be like, oh my bad. You know, I would have got down. Cause you know, like I understand. If you're gonna ask me like that, nah. Like I'm about to fuck up your night.
Fuck you.
What I should have got down. And then 5 minutes later, come back up and just go in the same spot and just start recording. But no,
that was sick.
Overall, though, that shit was hella fun. And I didn't know, people who might be watching that are from out of California might be like, what the fuck? That's hella normal. But bro, they have fucking drive-through liquor stores. You've seen that before?
Yeah.
Bro, I've never been out of California, so I've never seen that. Bro, I fucking pulled a 24 pack through the window.
Legend.
It felt pretty cool.
Honestly, when I went to Arizona, I went to a liquor store that sold burritos with French fries in them.
They're called Cali burritos.
Yeah. But I didn't know that at the time. I was, I don't know, younger.
Where was that at?
I was in Tempe.
Same place.
Yeah. This liquor store sold burritos.
What were you out there for? I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I'm just curious.
No, it's all good. My homie Vince, he went to Arizona State. So, like, I was going to just go visit
him. Asian dude?
Nah, the white homie. You never got to meet him when he was out here, huh?
I don't think so.
We didn't get to link together. But, yeah.
Oh, is that the day you were...
He's not white. I'm so sorry for saying that.
Is that the day you were on live with boobs?
Dude, apparently I went live sucking titties.
Yeah.
I don't remember this truthfully and honestly.
This man was on live sucking his girlfriend's titties. I'm surprised you're not banned from live. I got banned from live.
For sucking titties?
No. I wish I was sucking titties on live.
No,
I was on. I don't know what I did, but I got banned from live for like 2 months.
Damn.
And you have to suck titties on live and they just let you rock.
Influential.
I'm pissed.
I'm influential, changing the culture of life and what things should be happening. Everyone should be sucking titties. It's a natural thing for our bodies to do.
I'm not gonna lie. You know what I like to do? I like to, like, you know, like when you're laying down with a girl and you're kind of just like cuddling and shit and you guys are both naked. Kind of like to go like this with her titties.
Like a little violin?
Yeah. Bro, I was trying to explain what the, like, what it would be like for people who are just listening and not watching. But like a little violin, you know, you just, you know, rubbing back and forth. It feels nice.
Yeah.
It feels nice.
So you get this rotational with the thumb.
Man.
You just keep going.
Well, I mean, you have a girlfriend, but there's sometimes where like I see a girl and she's walking by.
You want to rub her titties?
No, I just want to like lay my face like on her butt cheeks and just like lay there. Like read my horoscope. Fucking just like watch a movie.
Let her fart a little bit.
Nah, no farts.
No farts?
No farts.
Okay.
But I just want to lay there and just like go through. I just want to go through Instagram.
I feel that you guys aren't that close yet.
I just want to like write some notes in my notes.
Write some notes in my notes.
Yeah. Or like maybe like get a canvas and hold it up with my hand. And the other hand, I'm just doing hella art, you know. But yeah. all the same time, I have my face on her cheeks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I'm saying
feel
like
that.
Because there's this one lady that works at my job. I was about to say works at my work. Like how
works
I said.
Works at my work.
Like how I said earlier. What did I say a second ago? I said, you just made fun of me for it. You don't remember either. Yeah, damn. All right, but yeah, like she works at my job and shit, but she's like some Colombian girl. Like they're all like immigrants and shit. Like, and they work doing recycling at Tesla. And bro, she has a fat ass, bro. But it's obviously fake. But I love it.
She got the BBL.
I love it, but she's like probably like 40 to 50 years old.
So you're gonna pull up or what?
She can't speak English.
So there, what is she?
A Colombian.
Dude, all you gotta do is learn like 5 phrases. She'll be like, damn, this thing is nice.
Or he tried. Or like, no, it's cute. He's trying.
Exactly.
One of these days, because dead ass, like, I look at her every day and I just shake my head, like.
BBLs.
I'm just like, girl.
Shout out to them OnlyFans, BBLs.
Oh, fucking.
Tummy tugs.
Oh, fucking.
The lips done. The eyes done. Honestly, whatever women want to do to create their beauty for themselves.
Totally with it.
Just do that.
Do it.
That shit's not for me, but whatever makes you feel good, I support what makes you feel good.
Yeah, but there's sometimes where I tell girls like, hey, you don't need to do that, but if it makes you feel better, do it. But I'll tell them like, yo, I'll tell them this way, like, yo, like, if it makes you feel good, do it, but I think you're good enough, and it's like, you don't need to, but if you want to, if it makes you feel happy, fuck it.
Yeah, I'm just
because you obviously want to like tell them like, yo, like you want to reassure them of their beauty. You know, you want to tell them like, yo, like you're beautiful enough already.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, if you want to, if that makes you feel better. Fuck it. You know, because if I want to do something to myself, which I never would. And it's like, oh, I'm going to feel better. You can't tell me shit because that's how I feel. You know?
Yeah.
But. Hey. Girls are a little different than guys are, though, for sure. For sure. Mm-hmm. Especially now, because like they all like they look at Instagram, they look at social, they look at all the TV, and they see all these girls that are just like unrealistic, and they be like, "Yo, I have to have that," and it's like you don't.
Yeah,
but that's what it is nowadays, though.
I mean, even for us guys, we're the same way too. We feel like we have to have.
What do you mean? What do you mean for guys? So honestly, I don't feel that way. Like, you probably don't feel that way either, but like explain, cause I'm sure like, I don't know. Like, what do you mean?
We're just inspired.
Oh yeah, for sure. As far as success goes, success. Yeah.
I mean, success, our fashion, it's all, it really is all who we are inspired by. Like, what we think is dope and what we think is cool is obviously inspired by something.
It okay.
Doesn't yeah. just stem from ourselves.
Yeah.
Which so, is cool. Like, because you get you know, to, yeah, you yeah, still get yeah. to make it, like, you're inspired.
You got a good point.
But you don't take the whole entire idea. Yeah. You still make it who you
put
are.
Your own sauce on it still.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, so I guess for guys, it's probably more likely to be clothes. But girls is more of their body because they just see girls have nice bodies. They're like, yo, how the fuck do I get that? But for bodies, us, like, cause,
makeup.
Yeah, because what you said, like, we're obviously inspired by something. So, like I said, like, I look at Pharrell, early BBC Ice Cream, skate shit, and that's what inspires me, and that's what makes me dress the way I dress. Mm-hmm. So what you said fits exactly into what I'm into.
Yeah.
But girls, they see bodies and they're like, yo, like, that's, because a lot of times a girl could, no, because there's girls that have nice bodies, but they dress like shit and they dress like in horrible shoes and horrible things. I'm just like, you're fine, but that turns me off so bad.
Mm-hmm.
Like, have you ever seen something like that?
Definitely.
When then girls wear some flights. You ever seen a fine bitch dressed in some flights?
I just want to know.
Have you seen that?
Yeah.
Tell me that doesn't hurt. It hurts your soul.
I just feel like, how uncultured and unhip are you to the fact that you wear flights willingly? And you don't know that flights are not fire.
And no one's telling you.
Yeah.
No one's telling you.
That means you are pretty bad. If no one's telling you.
Everyone's like, yeah, you.
Because if you're ugly, niggas be like, bro, you got the flights on something. You ugly bitch, bro.
But if you're bad, everyone be like, oh no, you look good. You're fine.
That's so funny.
Like, honestly, I was saying, but I had to tell that girl, she gave bad head one time. Have you ever had to do that?
Bad head?
Have you ever had to tell that girl she gave bad head?
No. I never had to tell a girl, like, yo, this sucks.
So I didn't tell her it sucked, but I was like, yeah, it's not that good.
You're a dick.
Dude, no, because pretty much it was good.
Unless it was just full on. With teeth.
It was good, but she gave it for like 3 minutes and she was just done. I'm like, bro, that's whack.
Mm.
If you give me here for 3 minutes, that's not a good head. I don't care how good it is. It depends. If it's like some like pregame shit, fuck it. You know, it's real quick, boom. But like this one girl, she's be like, oh, I'm on my period, but I'll give you a head. I'm like, oh, for sure. Thinking, no, I'm a nut, obviously, because she offered it.
Mm-hmm.
She'll quit after like 3 minutes. I'm like, so like, I would have rather just do nothing the whole night.
I hate you, bitch.
But like, I would have much, because this girl that I'm talking about, I would have much rather just did nothing the whole night. I would have much rather just watch movies and kick it and drink. But you tell me you're going to suck my dick, I think I'm going to bust a nut.
Mm-hmm.
After 3 minutes, just, oh, I'm tired. And one day I just told her, I'm like, yo, I'm not going to lie, like, your head game is not that great. And she's like, what? And I'm like, it's not that good. And she was like, are you serious? I'm like, yeah. And she was like, well, I always been told it's good. I'm like, were those same niggas jocking you hella heavy? And she was like, yeah. And I'm like, well, they're lying to you. I'm like, yeah. And then,
Will the pimp.
Hey, but no, I'm not a pimp. But guess what? Guess what? Next time I seen her, guess what happened?
She gave you top for 30 minutes.
It was
blowed your shit.
No, she gave me head for a longer time, and it was way better.
Just keep it.
But at the same time,
the moral of the story is keep it G real.
No, because at the same time too, because like real shit, like I want girls to do the same thing for me. Because if I'm not doing it right, tell me.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me what can I do better? Because I want to be the best as I can be.
Yeah.
I want to be the best human I can be. So if I'm not giving you good head, tell me, like, yo, like, what can I do better? Because there was one girl, I was like, yo, like, what can I do better? So you can do this better, you can do this and that. And I was like, thank you.
That's
like,
what makes things better for
that's
sure.
That's what, because every girl is different.
Because
every girl before that, they're like, oh, you give, it's fucking good. And I was like, okay, cool. And this one girl I did too recently, and she was like, oh, you could do this better. I'm like, all right, cool. Thank you. Like, I'm glad you told me, you know? Because I didn't tell her, like, oh, I give great hicks. Like, because I feel like if you brag, you know, you probably lying. But I didn't brag, but I was like, you know, like, yeah, like I love doing it. Cause I do, I love eating pussy, bro. Like,
eating pussies for the legends.
I could eat pussy for like 20, 30 minutes. Like,
for sure.
Dude, cause it's like, I love doing it. Cause like, bro, like, think about it. We're men, we love pussy. What's better than having pussy in your face? Nothing.
I'm just trying to crawl back in there.
I just want to just have
I'm trying to go home.
What's better than having your face in there? Nothing. Having your face in there and then seeing their reaction to it, it's the best. Mm-hmm. So it's just like, if I'm doing something wrong, fucking tell me. I want to please you. I'm here to do my job, baby. But yeah, man, like
I just got dizzy.
Yeah, when I seen you doing that, I was like, oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt.
I'm fucked up.
Yeah, no, I feel pretty good. I feel pretty good.
All right. Will's gonna be pissed right now, but
you're trying to end it?
No, I'm trying to play this song that I'm trying to hear, but I know it won't get
we can't play a song right now.
It's a minute and 30 seconds long.
You want to play a song that bad?
I do.
Kodak just got released. How do you feel about that, bro? Because I'm a big Kodak fan.
I'm not the biggest Kodak fan. I definitely listen to his music, though, for sure. I feel like...
I want to say this real quick. If y'all ever look at me looking at the camera, it's because I'm scared because I've been through so much shit with my old iPhones where I get this... I have PTSD, basically, with cameras, which I know this one records every time, and I know it's not going to go off, but I just have a bad habit of looking at it just to make sure. So if y'all see me doing it, give me a break.
Give him a fucking break.
But you say you're not that big of a fan.
I'm not a huge fan, but I definitely listened to his shit before, like for sure. I know a pretty good, decent amount of his discography.
You know what song that I fucking played for hours at a time? Because I said I used to fuck with this bitch back out in Brentwood, which is like, which is crazy because I live in Mountain House now, but I used to fuck with this bitch. And she stayed in Brentwood. So I had to I'd always have to pass through Mountain House. So this street, this main street right here, I had to pass through right there, turn left, and then go on this crazy ass fucking two-way street and go up there for a couple of miles and then finally get to Brentwood.
Yeah.
But I just play this one, the one song is like, "Everywhere you see me, I'm surrounded by snipers."
It's a classic. Your life, huh? That's like early Kodak for sure. Bro,
that's not even early though.
It's like his early stage of being popping.
Getting there, yes. Yeah, yes. Yeah. Because I remember when certain guys, they would tell me like, "Yo, you listen to Kodak?" I'm like, okay, so like I said, like I was very into like hip hop, fucking just lyrical shit. And so when the whole like ignorant kind of like SoundCloud rap started getting popping, I really wasn't into it. But I guess what was my introduction? My first song that I was like, okay, I fuck with this was it was Uzi, Rich the Kid, and ASAP Ferg. It's like, what do you want? What do you want?
Fuck, I don't think.
If I play it, you'll know. But it was like pretty much that. And after that, then I got slowly into Playboi Carti. Cause even like the fucking when Fetty started getting popping, I was like, I really didn't like it. But then when I heard it a little bit later, I was like, okay, I fuck with it. Like yeah. It's fire.
Yeah.
And then after that, then it got into one of the homies was like, yo, like cause that's when I first started listening to ignorant rap. Like ignorant and just turn up shit. And one of the homies was like, yo, like listen to Thousand Man Funny on Uno. And that's when I got into that nigga put me on. And that was
like Warhol.
And bro, that was early into like that in that sound.
Yeah.
So people went into that. And then I got into that. Then I got into Playboi Carti like deeper. After that, like that's what I'm saying. But when I first seen Playboi Carti, like I could have seen I'm saying this for the crowd, because I'm pretty sure I told you. but people who are listening, like, I was supposed to go to, it was Lil Uzi and Playboi Carti, and it was called the Left Right Tour. And bruh, tickets were $15. Imagine trying to buy tickets for Carti and Uzi now.
Yeah. I mean, they're like one easily 100.
Bro, probably even 2-3, and they'll still sell out.
Nah.
Yeah, you're right.
Not 2-3.
But like,
I saw some Jay-Z.
Yeah, you're right. But like, they could still sell for way, like 100, easy. Mm-hmm. But like, this shit was 15.
Yeah.
In Oakland at the Complex. And I was supposed to go to that shit, and I was like, I don't want to go. Bro, when I tell you I regret that shit so much, bro, because that would have been one of the most legendary concerts ever, bro, because that was them both when they're on their come up. And they were going to play all their old shit.
I just wish I could have got some merch.
That too.
I'm super big on merch due to the fact that I'm super big on like vintage like tees. So like, you know, obviously certain t-shirts you can only get from going to the actual concert.
So we're on the same kind of wave to where like I appreciate like collectibles and art. Mm-hmm. And I like that's why I have that right there. Remember that?
The tea party? Yeah, I was actually looking at that shit.
Do you have yours?
No.
The fuck?
You're the only person that has it.
What?
I lost it in the fade, brother.
Damn. No, I made sure to keep that.
Yeah.
I made sure to keep that.
That's
but like,
good memories.
And on some shit too, like, because I remember back in Modesto, like a couple of the homies, they had like these little flyers for like their shows that they were doing. And when I interviewed one of them, shout out Scan, I interviewed him. And he's seen it in my room. He's like, bro, I don't even have one of those.
Yeah.
But it's just because me, like, I'm big on memories. And I'm big on, like, moments. Like I told you earlier, like, I live in the moment. So I take certain shit that's going to remember.
Yeah.
It's going to memorize. I don't know the word, but basically I pretty much just, like, I want
memorable shit.
Memorable, yes. I want to keep things. I want to have things that are memorable. I want to have things that are memorable.
Right there, I want you to add that clip if you can find
it. I definitely will. But like, yeah, I like to have things that are memorable, you know? So like I said, I'm big on memories. I'm big on moments. I'm big on little things like I was talking about earlier in the podcast. So like, yeah, so like right there where I'm pointing at, if you're not watching the podcast, on my wall, I have a Tea Party LA thing. So when me and Nick and Jose first really hung out for the first time for 7 days straight, like I said, I knew Nick. I didn't know Jose, but I knew of Jose's shit.
And he didn't even know me like that at the time, which is even crazy. Like we were just cool, like we just seen each other around.
Can I tell you how like I first saw you and Jose hanging out?
Where did you see us hanging out at?
Not seeing you guys hang out. I mean, yes, I did. Seeing you guys. It was over the internet. It was on live.
Yeah.
And I was commenting the whole time. And you guys were like, I was making fun of it because it was funny. Like, so, like I said, me and Nick, we were cool before this. And then Nick was on live. And then Jose was talking to a certain person. And he was like, yo, you're... Dude, you're so beautiful. Your nose bridge is sexy. And hella shit. And I was just commenting like nose bridge mad sexy. And I was just commenting.
I remember that.
I was commenting hella funny, just dumb shit. And then, but I didn't know that Jose was doing the pants or designs that he was doing until I met him. And when I met him and then he showed me what he did, I was like, oh shit, that's you, bruh.
Yeah,
I was like, bro, like I seen your Slipknot pants hell long ago, and I think you even look back and look at my comment. Like, I commented, I was like, this is fire. Except I forgot who shared it, but I was like, this is crazy.
Yeah,
and then I fucking commented, and I was like, holy shit! I said, now these guys are my fucking best friends.
Making me
want
to call my brother, man.
Yeah, I don't know. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie. I love Jose. I love you, but I hate calling you because you disappoint me and hurt my heart every time.
Should we call him and see if he answers just to see?
you call him.
I'm pretty down just to be
because
like,
if you call him, it's a better chance. I feel like.
All right, guys, we're just gonna call just to see.
We're just gonna see if he joins. It'll be a good one.
No, I'm just calling him regular to the side because he has a better chance of answering there. And once again, that's how I know when Bree's back home.
She's always there, though.
She left for a week.
Oh.
I hate this bastard.
But, yeah, that was my introduction to my friends. So, yeah, it was just a fucking good time, man. So, let's move past this, though, because, you know, I feel like we've talked about this a good amount of times. But, I talked about the subjects I want to talk about. I mean, we kind of just freestyled it, and I think, I don't know, I covered a lot of ground. Is there anything you want to talk about?
No, I'm pretty good, honestly. And we've been on here for
pretty far in.
Hour and a half or so. We just be vibing, you know.
Yeah.
It's cool to have stuff written down, of course. But
it's also good to do this because this is pretty much us hanging out and forgetting the camera.
Yeah.
And this is the best part.
Yeah. So cause when I feel like when I write stuff down, it helps. But at the same time, I don't know. I just feel like it's more natural when I don't have anything.
It's more of us just kicking it and people watching.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what it's supposed to be.
Because when you kick it with your homies, you don't always have something to say. No. Right? Like, you guys would just be vibing.
Yeah.
Playing music, watching something, whatever.
How about this? Let's take one more shot and play that game one more time. And then we'll end it.
How about this? No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
One more time. One more time.
No.
Come on. For the people.
I don't want to.
Just one more time. One more time. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. I'm starting it up.
Whatever.
Come on. Let's take a shot first, and we'll do one more.
I hate my life.
This is for the fans, man.
Lil always pressures me. Alright, guys.
So right now I'm pouring Nick's shot. I had just poured mine. We're gonna take a shot and we're gonna do this shot game one more time. And out of that,
I need Chase because I'm a whore.
It's too late for that because we have none.
Not taking it.
Bro, what the fuck? You're acting like a fucking female. What the fuck? Like, bro, just take a shot.
Look how look how Will treats me.
It's not that hard.
On camera. He tells me I'm a female because I want to take a shot with the Chase.
I just want everyone to know this man drinks a lot. This man drinks a lot. And for him to ask for a shot for...
Why is he treating me like a female?
For him to act like he needs a fucking... He's a chaser for one shot is crazy to me.
Will's a sexist.
No. Come on.
Let's take the shot. If you take chaser, you're a female.
No, because I do chasers too, but we don't have any right now. So, yeah. We literally have nothing. You want to go downstairs? We have nothing. So, let's just take this shot.
Listen to Will.
Let's take this shot and let's finish this off.
Listen to how Will just treated me, guys.
No, I love you, bro. All
right, I'll see you in hell. All
right, let's play this game. All right.
Where's...
All right. That right there, one in the middle. All right, ready?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm just going to eat it. I'm not even going to react to it. I'm just going to say.
I'm not going to lie. I'm probably going to react to it because it's just like, it's so much like, there's so much adrenaline going through your body before you even get hit. It's just like, it's a lot.
I'm just going to choke myself out when it happens. Go.
Oh, you're dirty.
I'm
dirty.
Just so you know, I like to be choked out, ladies. I'm kidding.
All right. You really ate it. hand up. You had your hand up, didn't you?
No, I'm in it.
No, you didn't.
Bruh, what?
Okay, now you did. I believe you.
Come on. I'm not a fucking king. I just really had to eat it. It was a second.
My man ate it. My man ate it. So, what do you want to say to the people before we leave? Any thank yous? Any, you know?
I want to
just... We got to do shout outs too, but you know, you want to get. Oh, and we got to do an ASAP Yams quote, you know, pass it over here. It's under your.
ASAP Yams quote.
Oh, man. You think. Let's show off your hats first, you know? So, you know?
It's all good.
My this man brought his hats over. So, you know, go through your hat. I want you to do it. So, you know, this is yours. These are your products.
This is that Lamborghini high. You know what I'm saying? It's that AUG. You know what I'm saying? With the Lamborghini high. You know, LV Cloud logo, if you know, was good.
Yeah, so if y'all aren't watching and just listening, he's just showing off his hats that he brought through, so.
Some fire, pink brim, Dior.
That's fire.
Some Basquiat work on there as well. Must be nice, gang. Shout out my boy.
Must be nice.
My boy Luffy. Another one.
That Cloud LV is just so hard, bro.
Yeah.
That shit is ridiculous.
This is probably my favorite hat, honestly, which is crazy.
Why is that?
Just
so what he's holding up is it's a New York
Mets, sorry.
It's a New York Mets hat. It has like the sicko girl on it.
T-Rex
Global. It has fucking Mickey Mouse like outlined.
Vivian Westwood.
It has the fucking teddy bear from fucking Kanye West.
Graduation.
And on the patch it has the World Series 1986. And on the back, it has the Cloud LV logo, like, Virgil. And the brim is what? Like, what do you, it's like
it's butter. It's called butter.
It's called butter. So, yeah, like, this is just fucking sick, man.
It's
like,
a butter brim. Yeah, man, I just, people that are influential to me.
Yeah, this shit's ridiculous. This one's pretty ridiculous. I ain't gonna lie. There's just so much on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, if y'all aren't on my brother's shit, man,
White
fucking
Atelier.
Get on it, man. White
dot
Atelier.
Dot A-T-E, like 8, L-I-E-R.
I hate that you and fucking Jose change your guys' name so much, because like when I interviewed Jose, I had a certain name. And now it just changed.
I changed my name once, literally.
No, but Jose changed his name all the time.
Yeah.
So with him, I'm kind of glad I put his actual name. Mm-hmm. I might put his last name. I don't know what his last name is. I'm going to find out what his last name is. I'm going to put his Perez. Last name. Oh, yeah. Perez?
Jose Perez.
Oh, well, there you go. Well, now.
But, yeah, man. Honestly, I'm
fixing
really,
that right now.
I'm running this hat shit. And actually, if you want me to be honest.
Yeah.
I'm doing a FUBU White Atelier comparison video very soon, just because I get a lot of responses between yo, FUBU shit's more fire, yo, FUBU shit's dope, this and that. But I'ma really show you niggas what's good. My shit's not run of the mill. My shit you really can't duplicate. But I'm going to show you guys that. But we're not going to get into that. Shout out to Sade, because her birthday passed recently, I believe. Shout out to...
Ooh, I want to shout out Ashante, because like I said, we were watching Ashante versus Keisha Cole before we did this podcast. And Ashante's birthday is one day before mine. So I feel like that means something, honestly. I'm not going to lie. And like I said, I just want to lay on her booty cheeks and just read horoscopes. Both of our horoscopes. I want to read her horoscopes. I want to read my horoscopes. I want to just lay there, you know? And like, I just want to vibe out. I want to fuck one time. And then I want to have both of us just lay down and cuddle. And I want to play the violins with her nipples. And then we just lay there. And then I want her to lay her head on my left shoulder, you know? but then have her left leg over my left. Oh no, I want to have her left leg over my left leg. And we just lay there and cuddle for like a couple hours, watch a good movie. And then I want to have her have her bonnet on. So, you know, it's like right next to my face. It's kind of bugging me, but I'm not going to stand like I'm a real nigga. You feel me? So it's going to be right there, but I don't want it. But, you know, I'm not going to bug me because, you know, like I said, I'm a real one. You feel me? So it's not going to bug me. So I want it to be right there. And then I'm going to kiss it because, you know, I respect her. You feel me? I appreciate it. And then we're going to fuck one more time. And then we're going to lay down again, watch another movie. And she's going to lay on the same side one more time. And we just cuddle till we pass out. And that's my dream. I want to do the same thing also with Coil the Ray. I want to do the same thing with...
You unloyal bastard!
I want to do the same thing with Cecilia Lyon. Shout out to you.
Is she the one that sleeps with the basketball players?
No, she's a porn star. I want to do the same thing with... No, I'm going to keep it a little to Ashanti. But any other girls that want to do... Any girls that thinks that sounds like a good plan... I'm that guy. I like cuddling and like kissing.
Me,
but I will kiss you on the forehead all day long.
Me, my girl, and Kehlani.
I love kissing on the forehead.
Me, my girl, and Kehlani. Hit me.
Ooh, Kehlani too. Ooh. Kehlani.
Or what's that one artist name? Her name's Alina something? I don't know.
I don't know.
Alina something. You find me and you find my girl. And you hit us. And
a thruple.
I will
you guys will have a thruple.
Eat two coochies.
I just heard it today. A thruple.
A thruple.
That's it's a couple but three. A thruple.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed today. I had a good time. I'm sure you had a good time. Let's get this ASAP Yams quote in. Pass that over to me, brother. Bro, hey, a Thundercat on an interview. Fucking Hot Ones interview.
Yeah,
they asked him like, "Yo, what's your favorite soundtrack to video games?" He said Halo is one of the best ones.
Fire.
And it was. It really was. Because think about it.
Gas.
Halo had the mood for every scene that happened. And the orchestra was crazy.
Dude. Wait.
Go.
The shotgun with the hit. That means you're dead.
You're fucking done.
Do you guys know that?
Yes.
You get shotgun and hit.
I said this. Yes.
You get shotgun and hit. You're wrapped.
Yes.
Or if you get fucking headshotted by a sniper.
Yes.
Dude, oh my god, I used to snap in that shit. Ridiculous, bro.
Bro. Halo 3.
You say boom, cow.
And they're done. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. You're fucking done.
Yeah.
But. We could keep going for hours, but we already went longer than we were supposed to. Wait. Yeah. Okay, so
read the comment. I turned the phone
down. The ASAP Yams quote of the day is ran out of deodorant and spray myself for Febreze. I'm lit. I'm lit.
Spray myself for, hey, have you heard have you heard Thugged Out by ASAP Yams? He made a song called Thugged Out on SoundCloud.
I've heard some legit actual like ASAP Yams songs where he's actually like rapping, but he's fucking around, but he's actually rapping. It's pretty, yeah.
It's so fire.
Like Jay Worthy actually had one, but I think they took it off.
Mm-hmm.
But they had one where he was legit actually rapping and they took it off though, but yeah. But yes, we're getting off on that note.
I loved you, you bitch, but you blame me.
Shout out to Ashanti, shout out to Keisha Cole, you know what I'm saying? And shout out to New Era.
Shout out New Era. Yes. What's your shout outs? Go.
I just said them.
Just New Era?
New Era, ASAP Yams, Akeisha Cole, Ashanti. I want to shout out to this Flat Screen too. Shout out to Goodfellas. No, shout out to Martin Scorsese. Yes.
Shout out.
I'll end up right there.
Shout out Tarantino. Shout out Basquiat.
Hey, what Adidas are those? Show them shits.
These ain't Adidas, my niggas.
What are those?
These are Asics.
Pull the fuck that.
You gonna take my shoe off?
Take them off.
Oh shit!
Look at these. These are sick. These are tight.
Those are Asic Vivian Westwoods.
See the these are sick.
I think you're supposed to hold like money in the thing.
These are sick though. Here's your shoe back. All right.
Thank you.
Much love to everybody who's watching.
All right, we're almost done.
Like I said, I hope everyone has a good life. I hope everyone's doing good during this quarantine. I hope y'all are being safe.
I hope everyone's sick. And
one thing too, I hope everyone's grandparents are doing good. All that, because that's very, that's very important. I hope everyone's grandparents are doing good. Because once permission, like I've lit on my story lately and just on my timeline, I've seen a lot of people that I know whose grandparents have passed away from COVID. So I hope everyone's grandparents are being very safe. And on some real shit, not for real. But I hope everyone who is like out there and fucking around and shit, do not go and see your grandparents. I know how much you want to see them. Fucking FaceTime them. Don't go and see them.
I'm hearing Will, but don't I'm not listening them. To him.
Yeah, he's not. I know.
You guys knew Will, you'd say, Will, shut up, you idiot.
So what I just said is dumb?
Let's be honest.
Tell me.
Let's just be honest, brother. You're not practicing what you're preaching.
I have not seen my grandmother one time in like fucking almost over a year and a half.
I know.
I haven't seen my grandma in 2 years, actually.
But.
All right. So what are you talking about then?
We're not going to get into this on the live. We're going to talk to. I'm going to talk to.
Yeah, we're bringing it off and talk about it.
After this, we're going to talk about this.
Yeah, because.
I love Will.
I want to talk about this. Yeah, all right, for sure.
I love Will, but we're going to
talk about it. All right, we're done.